The home opener during the spring 2021 season for the South Dakota State football team is tomorrow afternoon as the Jackrabbits welcome the Fighting Leathernecks of Western Illinois into Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium. Hi friends, Tyler Merriam, and welcome to Game Day Eve as we get you set for SDSU and Western Illinois. Before we talk about tomorrow, let's talk about last Saturday, what was a disappointing day in the Alaris Center in Grand Forks for the Yellow and Blue as North Dakota, a 28-17 victor. Special teams has been such a huge reason why the Jacks have won countless games in the John Stiglmeyer era. It was a negative last Saturday. The Jacks had a punt block that resulted in UND's go-ahead touchdown, had a field goal blocked earlier in the affair, and UND really helped spin the game early with a fake punt that led to a first down conversion on what would become the Fighting Hawks' first scoring drive of the game. So the Jacks looked to improve on that side of the football. The two Yonke brothers, the twins, were exceptional at wide receiver on Saturday. Let's begin with Jackson. 7 receptions, 161 yards, and 2 touchdowns, doing it in a variety of ways, the combination of the speed and the physicality of the Madison native. But his twin brother, Jaden, not one to take a backseat to anybody, including his own blood. 5 catches, 109 yards for him. Second start for Mark Gronowski. He completed 16 of 32 passes, threw for just over 300 yards and a couple of touchdowns. And another solid yet quiet game for Pierre Strawn Jr. He ran 17 times for 95 yards. Preston Tetzlaff, the heart of the defense, he came up with 10 tackles and his first career interception. Logan Backus led the way defensively with 11 tackles. And how about the day Don Gardner had? 6 tackles, a pair of them for loss. He also came up with a couple of pass breakups in the 28-17 UND win on Saturday. That means the Jacks are 1-1 entering this game against Western Illinois. Leathernecks have not been on the Jacks schedule the past couple of years. This will be the first time SDSU will face Jared Elliott in his third year as the head coach of Western. The Leathernecks are 0-1 coming off a loss last Saturday to Missouri State. They did not play in week one. Their game was wiped away due to COVID-19 protocols. This is a young Western Illinois team that only returns 8 starters. I mentioned that 7 days ago, the Leathernecks lost to Missouri State 30-24 in Macomb, led that game 24-20 at the midway point of the fourth quarter, but the Bears able to pull away and score the game's final 10 points. One thing you'll notice about Western Illinois, a lot of individuals are involved in the offense. It is a bit of organized chaos. 30 rushing attempts Western Illinois had last week by 10 different players. So anybody and everybody that's in uniform may touch the football on offense. The quarterback, Connor Sampson, threw 46 times for 281 yards, and he hit 10 different receivers. To give you an idea of what Western will do offensively, they had the ball for right around 25 minutes in the game against Missouri State and ran 76 plays. So a lot of plays in a short amount of time by that Leatherneck offense. Let's talk about the Western Illinois defense a little bit. Only 3 starters are back. Linebacker Herschel Blankenship, number 49, led the team in the opener with 10 tackles. In the middle, linebacker number 13, Gary Benton Jr., made himself and his presence felt, including on a 75-yard fumble return for a touchdown against the Bears. Now, when it comes to special teams, Western Illinois has been solid in that aspect. The punter Adam Fellner, honorable mention All-Valley a year ago when he averaged better than 42 yards per kick. Justin Hall was an All-Valley selection last year as a kick returner. He and Tony Tate, number 1, will share those duties. Both have been electric in the return game. Again, it's the season opener as far as home games at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium during this most unique of campaigns for Jackrabbit football. 2 o'clock is the kick on Saturday. There are some tickets still available at jackrabbittickets.com. You can join us in person with the socially distanced crowd here at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium. We remind you that with the Summit League basketball tournament as well, there'll be a triple header of action on 570 WNAX, our flagship, but you can hear the pregame show and postgame show in its entirety on the Jackrabbit app or at gojacks.com/watch. Television coverage starts at 2 p.m. on Midco SN2 and ESPN+. The Jackrabbit football team hosts Western Illinois tomorrow at 2 o'clock.